የተከበራችሁ የሃይማኖት አባቶች፣ ውድ ኢትዮጵያኖች፣ ጥሪያችንን አክብራችሁ ውድ ሰዓታችሁን ሰውታችሁ እዚህ በማዕከላችን ከእኛ ጋር ስለተገኛችሁ በድርጅታችን በአርበኞች ግንቦት ሰባት ስምና እንዲሁም በኢትዮጵያ አንድ ኮሚኒቲ በሳውዝ አፍሪካ ምስጋና እናቀርባለን። እንግዲህ በተደጋጋሚ ጊዜ እኔ መድረክ ላይ በጥቼ ብዙ ነገር እያልኩ ነው። ጊዜ መሻማት አልፈልግም። ብዙ ሰዎች የአርበኞች ግንቦት ሰባት ከፍተኛ አመራር በስካይፕ ከእናንተ ጋር ለመነጋገር ስለሚጠብቁ ብዙ ጊዜ አልፈጅም። ምንድን ነው መጨረሻ አንድ ማስተላለፍ እንፈልገው ከወጣው ላይ ቀር አሁን ወንድሜ ቢኒያም ሲናገር በሶሻል ሚዲያ እንደሰማ ነው እንዳየ ነው በዛሬው ቀን ውድ የኦሮሞ ልጆች በዚህ በታላቅ በዓል ላይ ከአራት ሚሊዮን ህዝብ በላይ ተሳትፎ በሚያደርግበት በዓል ላይ ይህ ወያኔ ቲፒኤልኤፍ ዘረኛ መንግስት ምንም ስም ብንጠቅስለት የማይበቃው ምክንያት እየፈለገ ብቻ ምክንያት የሚፈለገው በቃ ሰው ለመግደል ምክንያት እየፈለገ ብቻ ዛሬ ይህንን ታላቅ የተከበረ በዓል ስንት የውጭ ቱሪስቶች ስንት የዓለም ህዝቦች ያለው የኢትዮጵያን ባህል የኦሮሞን ህዝብ ባህል ለማየት የመጡ ህዝቦች ባሉበት መሃል በሄሊኮፕተር በስናይፐር በሚፈልገው መልኩ አድርጎ ማንም አዛዥ ስለሌለበት ይህንን ያህል ወጣት ወደ ቤቱ ሳይመለስ በዓሉን ሊያከብር እንደመጣ ቀርቷል። ስለዚህ ወገኖቼ እነዚህ ልጆች እነዚህ ወጣቶች የሞቱት ለምንድን ነው? አሸባሪ ሆነው ነው? ምን ሆነው ነው? የነፃነት ጥያቄ በቃ ነፃነት ያስፈልገናል። ነፃነት የሰው ልጅ የተሰጠው ከእግዚአብሔር ነው። ከያደገበል ነው አይደለም? አዎ። ያንን ነፃነት ግን ሙሉ ሰው የመሆንን ጥያቄ ኢትዮጵያ ውስጥ ተነክፈን ስላለ ይሄንን እያንዳንዱ ወጣት እያንዳንዱ ኢትዮጵያዊ ሽማግሌ አሮጊት ህፃን ሳይቀር ነፃነትን በሰላማዊ መንገድ እየጠየቀ ነው። የነፃነት መልስ ግን በ21ኛው ክፍለ ዘመን በመካናይዝ ጦርና በሄሊኮፕተር ሲፈልገው በስናይፐር ሰውን መግደል ነው። ስለዚህ ወገኖቼ ዛሬ እዚህ ጋር የተሰባሰብነው ቁም ነገር ለመስራት ነው። በቃ ሌላ ነገር የለም። ቅድም ወንድሜ ቢኒያም ተናግሯል። በኢትዮጵያ ኮሚኒቲ የህዝባዊ ቤተኝነት አስተባባሪ ኮሚቴ የጥቁር እንቁጣጣሽ ብለን እዚህ ቤት ውስጥ ተገናኝተናል። ሁላችሁም እንዳላችሁ አስታውሳለሁ። በዛን ቀን ምንድን ነው ያለው? ግማሾቻችን ጫካ መግባት አለብን፣ ይሄንን ስርዓት መቃወም አለብን፣ ግማሾቻችን ይዘነው በሙሉ የመጣነውን ሳንቲም ለሚሆነው መልኩ ለመርዳት የተመለሰ ሰዎች አለን፣ በዛ ሰዓት ፍራንክ አያስፈልግም ብለናል። ዛሬ ግን ወሳኝ ሰዓት የቁርጥ ቀን ሰዓት ላይ ተደርሷል። ምንድን ነው የእኛ ኮንትሪቢሽን? ሌላው መተካ የሌለው ህይወት ከአንድ በላይ አንድ ሰው ከተመታ ከሞተ የሚቀጥለው ህይወት አያገኘው። ያንን ዛሬ የሞቱት ወንድሞቻችን ምስክሮች ናቸው። ስለዚህ ምንድን ነው ማድረግ ያለብን? አዎ ማድረግ ያለብን ነገር አለ። መደረግ ያለበት ነገር ምንድን ነው? እኛ በሰላም ወረዳ አለን፣ በጥሩ ኑሮ እየኖርን ነው። አትሊስት እዛ እየሞተ ያለውን ህዝብ ልንደርስለት ይገባል። እኛ ባንሞት እነሱም ከሚሞቱት እንኳን ሼር ልናደርጋቸው ይገባል። በምን በምንችለው አቅም ይሄ ስርዓት መወገድ አለበት። ማንም ሰው ይሄንን የኦሮሚያ አስራ አንደኛው ከሰላሳ ደቂቃ ላይ ደርሷል። እነዚህ ሰዎች ለዚህ ነው ሊመሩ ያሰቡትን ህዝብ ነው ወይንስ እንደዚህ እያደረጉ ያሉት? ምንድን ነው እንዴ? የሚያሳፍር የሚያሳዝን ነገር ነው። ስለዚህ ወገኖች ዛሬ የተሰባሰብነው ቁም ነገር ልንሰራ ነው። የአርበኞች ግንቦት ሰባት ፈንድሬዚንግ ቅድም አቶ ቢኒያም እንደተናገረው በተለያየ መልኩ በተለያዩ ክፍላት ሀገሮች ከደርባን ተጀምሯል። ዛሬ ጆሃንስበርግ ነው። የፈንድሬዚንጉ ትኬት በመሸጥ እንደገና ደግሞ አገር ወዳድ ኢትዮጵያኖችን በአካል ይሄድን በመጠየቅ ጥሩ የሚያነቃቃና እውነተኛ ኢትዮጵያውያንን መልስ ያገኘንበት ሰዓት ነው። ለዚህ ሪሊ እዚህም ያላችሁ ዛሬም በማዕከላችን ያልተገኙ ለሁላችሁም ታላቅ ምስጋና አቀርባለሁ። የኢትዮጵያ ሕዝብ ምንም በስደት ቢኖር ወያኔ ሊያታልለው ቢሞክር፣ እኔ ፐርሰናሊ ከጓደኞቼ ጋር ሄጄ ዞሬ ያየሁት ነገር ልቡ ከኛ ጋር ነው። ልቡ ከኛ ጋር ነው። በሚሆነው መልኩ ይሄንን ስርዓት ለመጣል ሁሉም ሰው ዝግጁ ነው። ወያኔ ወይውና ግን የወያኔ ዘር ያለበት ግን የመግደል ሁኔታውን እየቀጠለ ስለሆነ በምንም አይነት መልኩ ከኛ ጋር ሊቆም አይችልም። ስለዚህ ወገኖቼ እንግዲህ ሶስተኛው ፓርት ዛሬ ደግሞ እዚህ ጋር የምናደርገው የፈንድሬዚንጉ አንደኛው አካል የጫረታ ጉዳይ ነው። ስለዚህ በዚህ ጉዳይ ላይ ተሳትፎ አድርገን እያንዳንዷ የምናዋጣት ነገር በሙሉ የምናወጣት ነገር በሙሉ አስተዋጽኦ አላት። አንድ ጠብታ ውሃ ሲቆይ ባልዲ እንደሚሞላ ሁሉ የእያንዳንዳችን አስተዋጽኦ ለትግሉ አንድ አስተዋጽኦ ስላለው እያንዳንዳችሁ በምትችሉት መልኩ አስተዋጽኦ እንድታደርጉ እርዳታ እንድታደርጉ እንጠይቃለን። ካስፈለገ እኮ ሁላችን ልንሄድ እንችላለን። የፈራ ይመለስ ተብሏል። የመጨረሻው ዘመን ደረሰ። ማንም ይቀርልን። ማንም ወንድሞቻችንና እህቶቻችን እንደዚህ እያለቁ እነዚህ ሰዎች ይሄንን ዘመን ካለፉት ነገር እኛስ ውጭን ያለ ነው። ወንድሞቻችን ግን ይሄንን ቃል ለማለት ይከብደኛል። ሽንታቸው በሙሉ ይሸኑብን ይችላሉ። ከዚህ ያለፈ ነገር በሙሉ ያደርጉ ይችላሉ። ስለዚህ ይሄንን ነገር በምንችለው ነገር በሙሉ የሃይማኖት አባቶች በጸሎት በምህላ የሙስሊም አባቶች እንደዚሁ በጸሎት ሌሎቻችን ደግሞ በእውቀት ያለን በእውቀት ብር ያለን በብር ሌሎቻችንን በምንችለው መልኩ አድርገን ይሄንን ስርዓት በቃ ልንለው እንፈልጋለን። መጨረሻው ንግግሬን መቋጫ በፊት አንድ ነገር ማለት እፈልጋለሁ። ንግግሬን መጨረሻ የማደርገው በዚህ ጥቅስ ይሆናል። የኦሮሞ ገበሬ መሬቱ በገዛ መሬቱ ዘበኛ ሆነ። የአማራ ገበሬ መሬቱ ለሱዳን ተቆርሶ ተሰጥቶ፣ የጉራጌ ነጋዴ ከመርካቶ ተፈናቅሎ፣ በአጠቃላይ ሁሉም ኢትዮጵያ ሕዝብ በገዛ ሀገሩ ባሪያ ሆኖ እና የጥቂት የትግራይ ወንበዶች ጌታ ሆኖ መኖር ያበቃል 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 ያበቃል። የኢትዮጵያ ትንሣኤ ቅርብ ነው ቅርብ ነው ቅርብ ነው። አማራ፣ ኦሮሞ፣ ሁሉም የኢትዮጵያ ህብረ ቀለም ህብረ ብሔር ሁሉ ለዛች ሀገር የሚያደርገው አስተዋጽኦ ከፍተኛ ስለሆነ ወገኖቼ እጅ ለእጅ ተያይዘን የመጨረሻውን ዘመን ልንወጣው ልናልፈው ይገባል። አሁንም የፈራ ይመለስ የፈራ ይመለስ። አመሰግናለሁ።
245 ጂፒ የኦሮሞ ኮሚኒቲ ተወካዮች እዚህ አሉ። እነሱንም ወደ መድረክ ጋብዙ። አንዴ ባክፈር ባክ
to speak in English a little bit. I don't want it to take you a long time. The highly respected religious fathers, all the participants, comrades, really to take your time and come here and express your concern. I really feel from the bottom of my heart that today is really very dark day for all of us, and I really wanted to share with you what is really happening today is very bad, and indeed is very bad, and everybody recognize that. And everybody wanted to say, enough is enough. As my comrade said, the one we fear, let him go back. We don't want any fear here with us. And really, I don't see much ladies here. Ladies is part of the struggle. If they are less, we are also, part of us is less. We are not really strong enough. But this struggle needs all the religious fathers, all the people who are educated, who can help lead the struggle with their knowledge, and people who got money, people who got their, themselves to participate in the struggle, and everybody need to fill a gap. That is why we are here. And that's why I said, really, all of you, thank you very much for the opportunity to come around and say what you feel. So, my appreciation to you all. In another way, Afan Oromo Tijon to Padetu Nagamachi Saruga Lupatu. Dugaan bacaan guia nara guia gadat. Karena berarti nama guia gamacu jenne guia yane reca gudu oromia kesa umane kenya be harsade bakjaram harobisof turut umane million afuri all tahan erata gamani yacu. Guia kuni guia itu wakayon wakga gudu nudevise jenne. Malkati dufne wan kamun kakabus wan kamun kankamnes humne isatin biate waga guraj baka kutunu devite oye ne itikarata kalfatu. This is the Thanksgiving day. Today is a Recha day. And in sense that everybody got belief and the faith. Oromo got their own faith whereby they link to Almighty God. They say the whole living from day one up to day last, the whole year, God is the one who can provide you everything. Energy, food, life, life, love, living in general. And that God needs to be thank you. God, you are the one who provide everything. We are giving you thanks for that. That is the day. And indeed, today it was more than 4 million people who was pilgrim, whereby many people, they come from, some of them from America, from Australia, from all over the world, but mostly they came from Oromia region. And we got another people, we noticed very strongly noticed that some Amhara people come from Gondar full with four buses. And all of them to share the feeling of Oromo, because these days we have common enemy and a common feeling. We don't know who died, who been left, survived. But Wayane decided to spray anti-human beings poison on Oromo pilgrimage. And the kill so far noticed about more than 300 people died this morning. But since yesterday and the whole week, people have been dying from where they are coming along the road. Many of them been arrested, some of them disappeared. We don't know where they are. But the killing of today, it is historical page. Historical page in Ethiopia, especially in Oromo. We have long history fighting against Ethiopia. But today, when my comrade was speaking, I was having one question. Everybody know, everybody love peace. Everybody love democracy. Love each other. You know the reality that Oromo and Amhara have been made as mice and a cat. the politicians who formed that image. We know that. We know Amhara have been oppressed originally from where they have been. But the political elites say this, we are proudly Amhara, but the Poch or Oromo, from urban, from education, from everywhere. That says, okay, if from Mililik up to Mangisto and Amhara, everybody is Amhara and Oromo, they will participate properly, what is happening really? These Amhara, are they thinking for us goodly, as human beings, they are equal. Even from religious-wise, and we think sometimes orthodoxy are maybe somehow so politicized. That thing is need to be brainwashed. All of us say, no, that particular poison been planted. But this generation, what are you thinking? If we say Ethiopia, Zalala Minur. Yes, in that sense, we do have question mark. This generation need to change the mentality of human being, much one is super than the other one. Historically, Oromo be known the hero of defending the name today Ethiopia. But they've been avoided. I can quote one time, Addis Lassie came from Addis. He came to Chiro, Dr. Isia Aspatafari. And that Aspatafari been given name to somebody who is a fighter for Addis for a very time. But Oromo were not happy. But anyway, let me take you to a little bit historical things. Whereby Oromo peasant, they came to make bluff, the farm, very big farm, Chishanyoch, Yapala farm. Then, because there is something what they call it Irbo, everybody, the farmers, they have something, they live in that land, whatever they harvest, they have to eat. No, when they were harvesting now, by helicopter, he came and his last year with his security guards, he saw. During the night, Oromo were plowing. You know what they call Dogora? There is a very heavy thing on top, there is a stone. Then they repeat three times without missing the target. Three times. Then they plow very big land whereby they want to change them for more plowing. Then Lissilase said, no. These guys, if they are trained, army, how to kill. Nobody will remain. Because now, look, it is night time, no nothing, no light, no nothing, but three times without missing the target, they repeat it the same place. So no, forget Oromo from the army, very distant from the economy, very distant from the education. Which is very bad. That is the kind of history we pass through, and that is why sometimes we have grudge with Amhara, but nothing, we know nicely that plantation was put with certain element, certain group, not all of us. So currently we are pleading, we are asking the young generation to stand and say no discrimination at all. That is in our heart. In 1980s, I participated in meeting, very great meetings, whereby Oromo elites, we sit down and we talk about how Oromia develop. How Oromia and what is in Oromia, including Amhara and the other nations, small groups, going to live in Oromia. We had some group which said, we don't want any single Amhara people in Oromia land. Any single. Sometimes people will talk, they call us Abab. That things, the narrowness is not for nothing, but it is for what had happened already from the beginning, Then other people, they say, no, these have been pushed to the very bad corner, and they try to retaliate. That is how things happen. But later on, we managed to control that feeling and say, Amara, for three generations, four generations, have been here in Oromia, they have equal right with Oromo people. That is what we do. We know Amaras are our brothers and sisters. We live together in that land. But we also feel sometimes very bad that Amara, why they think so Ethiopianism, much than anybody else. And we need to feel together as anybody feels. If it is to feel, we feel together equally. If not to feel, as though we feel other alternative equally. That is what I'm telling you. We don't have any problem with Amara people, and even today's Tigrayans, we don't have problem, any problem with Tigray. We are fighting against the system, against the government system. But when we count from Menelik who conquered the Ethiopian today, and what mistake he did, what good things he did, we have to edit and nicely come forward equally, whereby everybody feel included and inclusive included and feel safe with that name. If somebody not feel safe, then let us think alternative, whereby everybody think feel safe. That is how Oromo mentality thinking. But otherwise, we don't have any problem. Thank you very much. And the other thing. Like 1,000 people, like we got Somali people, Sidama people, Anyoa, Gambellas, all. They are fighting against Ethiopia since Ethiopia been formed. But you guys, you have to think why. Why this fighting is going? Because they are all bone shifter? No, actually not all bone shifter, but there is something wrong with the system, and that is why they feel they are not included. And that's why they feel embarrassed and left out and marginalized. And that marginalized come up to date with this this one you call it. So primitive people who even poisoning people. Today is 21st century, but we don't need to think the way they are thinking really. And tomorrow, if we perform in Ethiopia, we want to perform better Ethiopia, which is Horn of African nation, not even. What is today's Ethiopia, but also we expand and say, if we come to the term of Horn of African state, we don't have problem with it. But we need safe place whereby everybody think, feel, home, it is my 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 home. The last thing for Weyane is today, whereby they poison Oromo people by helicopter and they snap us. Today is last minute for it. Yeah. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. We don't want Wayane anymore. We don't want Wayane anymore. Enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
Enough is enough. Amara blood is Oromo's blood. Oromo blood is Amara's blood. We don't want any discrimination against any human being. We are all. We need to understand when we say that, we don't repeat the mistake. We don't want to repeat the mistake. So in this case, really, I'm very happy to see many faces I've never seen before, and some of you guys, you know me personally, and some of you, maybe you don't like me, some of you do like me, but today we come to the conclusion, we love each other. Because of one goal we wanted to achieve, which is to remove this Wayane and replace with but I prefer to say a very well-known, expanded Horn of African nation.
All of you can speak today. All of you can speak. All of you can speak. All of you can speak. But all of you can speak is the best in my mind, really. Let me tell my thing. Because we can come up to Kenya, we can go up to Djibouti, we can even include up to Sudan. The Ethiopian, the state of Ethiopia where the Greeks say, we expand up to even South Sam, up to eastern part of the Kenya. And even Africa, because we could. But in a state we are Kushite. That Kushite empire has to be restored. Do you agree?
Yes.
Including Solomonic. No problem. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And my colleagues are not complaining. This time, I'm consuming time, but this consuming time is very expensive time. Actually, I know that. Guys, let us go together. Let us remove together, stand together. But we take care of each other so that we don't embarrass each other and repeat the mistake. And again, create another conflict in Ethiopia. Thank you.